The Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, your Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, who through the regenerating power of baptism have been pleased to confer on us heavenly life, grant, we pray, that those who render capable of immortality by justifying them may by your guidance attain the fullness of glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
For the first reading, please take page number 135 of the New Testament. The first reading is taken from the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 16, verses 1 to 10, on page number 135 of the New Testament. Paul came also to Derbe and to Lystra. A disciple was there named Timothy, the son of a Jewish woman who was a believer, but his father was a Greek. He was well spoken of by the brethren at Lystra and Iconium. Paul wanted Timothy to accompany him, and he took him and circumcised him because of the Jews that way in those places, for they all knew that his father was a Greek. As they went on their way through the cities, they delivered to them for observance of the decisions writ which had been reached by the apostles and elders who were at Jerusalem. So the churches were strengthened in the faith, and they increased in numbers daily. And they went through the region of Phrygia and Galatia, having been forbidden by the Holy Spirit to speak the word in Asia. And when they had come opposite Mysia, they attempted to go into Bithynia, but the Spirit of Jesus did not allow them. So, passing by Mysia, they went down to Taurus, and a vision appeared to Paul in the night. A man of Macedonia was standing, beseeching him and saying, "Come over to Macedonia and help us." And when he had seen the vision, immediately he sought to go on into Macedonia, concluding that God had called us to preach the gospel to them. The word of the Lord. Our responsory psalm is taken from Psalm 100 and our response to the psalm. Cry out with joy to the Lord, all the earth.
Cry out with joy to the Lord, all the earth.
Cry out with joy to the Lord, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before Him, singing for joy. Our response? Cry out with joy to the Lord, all the earth. Know that He, the Lord, is God. He made us. We belong to Him. We are His people, the sheep of His flock. Our response? Cry out with joy to the Lord, all the earth. Indeed, how good is the Lord. Eternal His merciful love. He is faithful from age to age. Our response? Cry out with joy to the Lord, all the earth. Please stand for gospel acclamation.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
If you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to His disciples, "If the world hates you, know that it has hated me before it hated you. If you were of the world would love its own. But because you are not of the world, but I chose you out of the world, therefore the world hates you. Remember the word that I said to you, a servant is not greater than his master. If they have persecuted me, they will persecute you. If they kept my word, they will keep yours also. But all this they will do to you on my account, because they do not know him who sent me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to the Lord Jesus Christ.
Who is Jesus to you? A suffering servant or glorious king? Who is Jesus to you? Who is Jesus to you? Glorious King. How He became glorious King? By suffering. Without suffering, there is no kingship. That's why we read in the Gospel, if they persecute me, they will persecute you too. In our life, if we get sufferings, we feel bad, we feel sad, we run away, we commit suicide. Why all these things coming to me? We don't want to take sufferings. We don't want to take pain in our life. Jesus is the example. He is the model for us, because He's telling, I have undergone all these things. Now, Father has glorified me. Cross-less life is not a Christian life. We have to always remember, without cross, we are not Christians. We always put a cross around the neck, we keep the ring, and we hang in the houses. It's not just we keep just for the fashion. We are to be model. We are to exemplary life in this world. then we become his disciples. Without sufferings, we cannot attain the kingdom of God. We read Matthew Gospel chapter 5 verse 10. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. All those who undergo sufferings for the righteousness' sake, we will have kingdom of God. Basileia, in Greek we speak Basileia. Basileia means where there is joy, peace and happiness. If you want joy, peace, happiness, we are to suffer in this world. If you don't want to suffer, we are not going to enter into that Basileia, that kingdom of God. We read St. John's Gospel chapter 16 verse 20. Your sorrow will turn into joy. All those who suffer in this world for righteousness' sake, we will have happiness in the future. So let us ask for this grace in this Holy Eucharist.
In bread we bring you, Lord, our body's labor. In wine we offer you our spirit's grief. We do not ask you, Lord, who is my neighbor, but stand united now, one in belief. Oh, we have gladly heard your word, your holy word, and now in answer, Lord, our gifts we bring. Our selfish hearts may true, our failing faith renew, our lives belong to you, our Lord and King. The bread we offer you is blessed and broken, and it becomes for us our spirit's food. Over the cup we bring, your word is spoken. Make it your gift to us, your healing blend. Take all that daily toil, plant in our hearts for soil. Take all we start and spoil, each hopeful dream. The chances we have missed, the graces we resist, Lord, in the Eucharist, take and redeem.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept sacrifices into your hands for the praise and glory of his name,
for our good and good of all this holy church.
Let us pray. Accept in compassion, Lord, we pray, the offerings of your family, that under your protective care, they may never lose what they have received, but attain the gifts that are eternal. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to love you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. By the oblation of his body, He brought the sacrifices of old to fulfillment in the reality of the cross and by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim,
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took the bread and, giving thanks, and broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more, giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, Lord Jesus, until you come, until you come in glory.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Thummabal our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember, Lord, your servants, Cyril James Lestrogen, Rome Fernandez, Antumani Paul, Fatima Nirmala, Paul, Mary Amius, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that they who are united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, her chaste spouse, Blessed Joseph, with the blessed apostles, St. John Maria Vianney, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world,
grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who call to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. But only say a word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let there be peace in our hearts. May love your peace with this nation. Cause us, O Lord, to arise. Give us a fresh understanding. Brotherly peace that is real, let there be peace shed amongst us. Let there be peace. Let there be joy shed amongst us. Let there be joy in our hearts. May now your joy sweet this nation. Cause us, O Lord, to arise. Give us a fresh understanding. Brotherly joy that is real. Let there be joy shed amongst us. Let there be joy.
Let us pray. Keep safe, O Lord, we pray, those whom you have saved by your kindness, that redeemed by the passion of your Son, they may rejoice in his resurrection, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended, goes in the peace of Christ. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Kindly take hymn number 476. 476. Immaculate Mary, your praises we sing.